Good morning.
Good
to see everybody on this beautiful day. Got several announcements that we want to get in touch with today, and so I'm going to begin there. First of all, don't want to miss birthdays. Anybody celebrate a birthday last week or this coming week? Huh? Who are you pointing at? Becky? Oh, okay. Oh, so Becky is having a birthday. Well, I have it on good authority that she likes anything to do with mouses. So if you, or mice, if you, mouses. Hey, that works for me. I likes mouses. Anyway, just kidding on that. Well, anybody else? You're having one?
I had one.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Oh, well, you look like you had a couple.
I did. I was always excited to get to 40, but when I got to 40, now
it rolls. Yeah, you start backwards.
Yeah, that's a long time.
There's a lot of people looking at you right now. 40.
Good.
All right, so how about anniversaries? Anybody celebrate an anniversary? We've got several birthdays.
I think Miss Edith said she had a birthday last week.
Yeah, last Sunday. And thank y'all, everybody, participated in the cards. I hope you enjoyed your cards when you got home. And so we'll celebrate your birthday last Sunday, too. Anybody else? Don't want to miss nobody. All right, let's sing happy birthday to all of these.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. God bless you. Happy birthday to you.
All right. Good deal. Okay. A couple announcements. First of all, despite the lovely weather outside, we will still be having our senior adult Christmas party after service today. So we invite anybody that... is 55 and older. Melissa's been making fun of my message all week because apparently in the message I said 55 and older. So I heard that a couple times. But anyway, 55 and up, you're invited to stay. We've got games and food and prizes and door prizes and gift certificates to eating. And they've got all kind of stuff planned today. So certainly hope that you will stay and enjoy that fellowship. Several folks got directories. That's been in the vestibule, so that's been replaced, and so if you still need one, there's one back there. Also back there is our minute book, or the annual session for the Ash Baptist Association, and on it, you'll see a very familiar road. Where's Peggy at? Peggy, I reckon you saw this, y'all seen this road a few times. This is T-Berry Road, taken by none other than our own.
No, not Campbell.
I mean Campbell. What did I said T-Berry. I apologize. Campbell Road.
It runs off of T-Berry.
Campbell Road. Anyway, taken by none other than our Ed Reed. And in the associational directory, we've got a whole page dedicated to Mr. Ed Reed. Actually, it says Ed and Geraldine. So, if you want to pick one of those up, they're back there as well if you'd like to read that. I'm not going to read the whole page. It's very lengthy, and Ed said half the stuff in here ain't even true. But it is. Very, very good write-up. Well, you're a humble man, but we do appreciate all you've done. So that's pretty interesting. If you'd like to read that, Brother David uses Ed's pictures every year, so we always appreciate that.
I'd like to say that I've never asked him to use one at all, but I told him if he didn't have more sense to ask for one, I didn't have more sense to give it to him.
There you go. All right, just a reminder about next week, Easter services. Of course, we're hosting that this year. So, Doris, do we need to know anything about next Sunday morning? Bring breakfast food. Bring supper food. I eat supper for breakfast because I eat breakfast for supper. So, I mean, hey. But just I just eat anything. That's right, Patsy. So please bring food. We'll be hosting, and of course, the sunrise service at 7 o'clock up on the hill. And then we'll have breakfast, and then we'll have a regular services. So looking forward to that. And I've got that on my thing. What screen? There's no evidence of that, Wendy. So once again, I made another mistake. Okay, so the 20th, I apologize. That's Saturday. Anything else you need to say about that? Bring a bunch of kiddos. Going to have a lot of stuff here, so that. So, invite your neighbors. Bring your neighbors. That'd be better. Just bring your neighbors. That'd be good. Let me read this card. Thank you for helping us with the service for Irene Osborne. Family, appreciate your kindness. We appreciate your willingness to help us serve the meal. And this comes from Pleasant Chapel Baptist Church. And I think Kathy wants to say a word for the family. All right. Deacons, we'll have a meeting this coming Tuesday. Kevin, it's this coming Tuesday. Where's Kevin at? All right. Any other announcements? Well, we'll begin our worship service today. We want to welcome everybody here, guests and members alike, and we're just glad that you chose to be with us today, and we love having you. Today, of course, we will be the adult choir is going to be presenting their cantata. And in the name, oh, what a Savior. Amen. And we certainly have a wonderful Savior that we serve, and we love Him. Amen?
Amen.
We love Him because He loved us first. And so we're doing things a little bit different today. So let's go, as we go now into the Lord in prayer, then we'll sing our offertory hymn, then we'll get right into our cantata. So, any special prayer requests this morning?
Pearl Ashley broke her hip and had surgery yesterday.
Okay.
Pearl goes for treatment Friday.
All right.
We need to remember Lois.
Yeah, let's remember Lois. Spoke with her via text this morning, and she said she's praying for us, and I said we'd be praying for her, so. Appreciate all the folks that went over and visited her. She sure liked that. She told me about the wild bunch that came over the other day. All right, let's remember, continue to remember Virginia and Edith and her family today. I remember that family in Deep Gap as well. Just remember our world. There is a lot of evil in this world. But I'm telling you, there's one greater. Greater is He that's in me than he that's in the world. Yes, thank you, Ralph Davis. Talked to Larry Shepherd this morning, and so Ralph should come home today. So I got a pacemaker inserted, installed, and Ralph's doing well, so hopefully he'll come home today. All right. Well, let's pray together. God, we just thank you for this day. We thank you, Lord, each and every day that we get up. It's a blessing. It's a gift. And, Lord, we pray that we'll use this gift to the best of our ability. Lord, we have so many that's sick, so many that is feeling bad today. We pray that you'll bless them and help them feel better. Lord, for all these requests that's been mentioned, we pray that your will would be accomplished. God, we know that you work in and out of our lives. You create us. You know exactly what we need to be healed. But Lord, we pray for your will to be accomplished. We pray, God, that that in all things that they're done to glorify you. May you receive glory from our lives, from this service. We pray for the choir members today, Lord. We pray, God, that you would bless them, bless their voices. But Lord, let us recognize that as we hear these words and we begin to think about our Savior, your Son, Jesus, it's all about him. And we thank you so much for Jesus today. Lord, as we celebrate today, Palm Sunday, as we think about the Lord Jesus riding in, Lord, and folks were so happy to see him. Lord, I'm mindful that some of those same folks is the one that cried, crucify him. So, Lord, today as we begin this holy week, that we celebrate each and every Sunday, God, as we think about our Savior who gave his life for us, but promised that he'd be coming back. Let us live victoriously through the grave, through the resurrection, the ascension, but hallelujah, the return of our Savior. He's a mighty one. For it's in his name I pray. Amen. Brother, you come and lead us.
Let's all stand and sing hymn number 233.
Soul shall find. What a Savior we have in Jesus Christ. And what a victory we celebrate today. John 1:1 says that he was in the beginning with God, and he is God. Yet he willingly emptied himself of his glory, and he took on the nature of a servant to save us.
I'm
A life of love had led Jesus, but not to admiration and applause, but rather to suffering and death. But this is why he had come. Jesus laid down on the cross a willing sacrifice for us. Scripture tells us that everything went dark as Jesus hung on the cross. The sun disappeared as he completed the sacrifice and then yielded his life. The women who had followed him, watched from a distance. Two influential but secret followers buried his body. Pilate had a heavy stone rolled across the tomb's entrance, and he posted a guard. But all that happened before Sunday came. The stone rolled away, and the women arrived to hear the glorious news. the story of Easter, the message of every Sunday morning, and the testimony of every redeemed soul is this. God's only Son, Jesus, came into this world, and he lived a sinless life among men. Then he laid down that life, a perfect atoning sacrifice for our sin. He rose from the grave victorious. So how can we help but give him all of our worship and take down and not take up our cross and follow him?
Over in Matthew chapter 16, verse 24. Hold off just a minute, Edith. Just hold on just 1 second. Just want to read this scripture real quick. Sorry about that. Matthew chapter 16, verse 24. The Bible says, "Then said Jesus unto his disciples, I've heard this several times already this morning. If any man will come after me, let him deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. For whosoever will save his life shall lose it. And whosoever will lose his life for my sake shall find it. For what is a man profited if he shall gain the whole world and lose his own soul? Or what shall a man give in exchange for his soul? Verse 27 says this, "For the Son of Man shall come in the glory of his Father with his angels, and then he shall reward every man according to his works." I just want to say just for a second this morning, very quickly, as we go back and look at Matthew 16, verse 24, Jesus gives us a choice. And every person in here has a choice. Amen. He said, "If any man will come after me." Every single one of us has a choice every single day to choose to go after Christ or choose not to. In fact, multiple times throughout the day, we're given that choice. And then Jesus says, if a man will come after me, says, let him deny himself. That's difficult. And so there, I believe, is a challenge. So every day of our lives, Jesus says you have a choice to make and also a challenge every day. Believer, this morning, I know that you have been serving the Lord for years and years and years. You know that experience each and every day. Every day, a choice and a challenge. Let's pray. Today it is my prayer that each and every person in the sound of my voice has made that choice. My prayer today is that you'll not leave this place today until you've made the choice to take up your cross and follow Jesus. The greatest decision you'll ever make. Father, we pray that your Holy Spirit, Lord, might move in this place this morning. And Lord, that heart you're convicting or that heart that you're giving this challenge to today, I pray it'll have the strength, Lord, to choose to follow you. With heads bowed and eyes closed, while Miss Edith just plays softly. Every one of us has a choice. I want you to know this altar's open. The Lord has put it on your heart that you need to be at the altar this morning. Would you come now? With heads bowed and eyes closed, I'm simply asking this question to you. Have you made that choice to follow Christ? And I'm going to ask you to do this. And no one's looking around. It's just between me and you and the Lord. If you'd simply like to lift your hand, a finger, whatever the case might be, just to let me know to be praying for you, because you know that the Lord has been tugging at your heart to accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior. I'm not going to embarrass you. I'm not going to ask you to do anything. I'm going to ask you to just to lift a finger, a hand, whatever the case might be, so that I know to be praying for you. And then for those today that you know the Lord's been speaking to your heart each and every day about that challenge and making that choice to take up your cross daily, to be on mission for Him, this altar's open. As we just contemplate and pray to our Father. He washed it white as snow. Amen, church. Well, what a Savior.
Amen.
I want to say thank you to each and every person that came out today, members and guests alike. We just love the fact that you are here today. That's a blessing for us that you chose to be here today. I want to say a big thank you to Miss Edith and the choir. Would you let them know? They work each and every week. They work so hard on this, and it was such, the words is just incredible. Very timely for us today. And we appreciate you, choir, each and every week. Appreciate your hard work. And appreciate Brother Scott and his dramatical readings. It's a blessing. When I hear him speak it, it's a blessing. I don't take that lightly. I think he needs to preach next week. One of these days. All right. Anybody got a word to say?
I love Jesus.
Amen. Anybody else love Jesus? He's so good to us. All right. Again, thanks for being here. I'm going to pray and dismiss, and let me just say again. If you're here today and you wasn't even planning on staying, go ahead and stay if you're 55 and older. Love to have you stay. We're going to have a good time. Appreciate those all who will. Let's pray and be dismissed. Let's stand together and...
with us, each and every one, as we leave and go out in this old world, just put that hedge of protection around us and just lead us and guide us and direct us in everything we do.